I got these Batchelors pasta sauces from Iceland and they're 50p each. And there must be an ampersand shortage at Batchelors because they love using the instead of the and. But they do use it for chicken and mushroom, cheese and broccoli, and cheese and panacetta. But, you know, sod mac and cheese, that'll have to stick with the Just use an ampersand. What's the problem, Batchelors? Anyway, let's get these reviewed.
The kettle broke. But look what we've got now. It's a Breville one cup thing. My mum and dad had one of these for years and it was really, really good, but they've never got around to replacing it because it did finally pop its clogs. But I'm hoping I'll be able to do that. So this one is cheese and broccoli. Oh, why? So that's meant to reseal and go down, but that's not happening, is it? Oh well. So since cheese and broccoli, it does smell future-future. Hang on, that'll take a while. Have a smell. Can you smell that? It does smell a bit like cheesy feet, to be honest. But mac and cheese and broccoli and mac and cheese always smells a bit like that, doesn't it? So, come on. This is a future review, this. You'll be seeing this very soon. Got from Poundland, that. So, I'm hoping this goes to the LAN. There is a LAN. Yes, and it does! Yay! That's great. So, now you've got to do that, and then you've got to mix that in. And make sure it's all stirred in. But we've got, yeah, that'll open properly. Have a good smell. This one smells surprisingly very similar to the mac and cheese. So we'll do that for that. I'll have to get separate forks, won't I? Because I don't want any smells or flavours to be mixed in. So I'm going to mix that in like that. Because it says make sure it's all mixed. So that's definitely all mixed. Then reseal, it says in the instructions, which I'd have loved to have been able to do, but that one did that stupid thing. So that's that one. So, this is not plumbed in, by the way. You got to like fill it up, which I think you're going to have to see at some point. So that's that one. Nice and mixed, then you've got to leave that one. Got to leave it to let the pasta do its thing. This is the chicken and mushroom. Have a good smell. What's that smell like? Oh, you can't tell me yet, can you? This isn't live. Ooh, that smells nice. That smells very chicken and mushroomy, doesn't it? Oh, that's a good smell. I like that one. I love this. This is so much better than boiling a kettle of water. And this is the first time I'm using it like this, so now I know that so far it's 3 cups of tea or coffee, isn't it? But my mug that I make my coffee in is like twice the size of this, so I do have to press the button twice to fill the cup up. So that's that one. Give that a good mix. Make sure it's all mixed in. By the time I've done this, I should be able to go back to the first one and we'll be able to try it. The consistency is quite watery when you first put them in, obviously. So that's that one done. I forgot what the first one was now. Oh yeah, that one, wasn't it? Ah! And now let's try this one. Have a good smell, future YouTube. Does that smell good? Oh, that smells nice as well. I like the smell of the last two more than the first two. That is very good. And this was filled up to the max. And now it's just got to just above the minimum. So now we know how many cups of tea or coffee it makes. It's really good, isn't it? And I don't know, actually, from when my mum and dad had theirs, you can get away with another one. I mean, it's just got to the minimum now, but you can actually sneakily get one extra cup out of that. So we'll give that a good mix. Make sure that's all mixed in. And then we'll go. And then you've got to leave that one. I'm hoping now that the others are thickened up. But whilst we're going to do that, I'm going to show you how to fill this up. So what you do is just move the camera slightly forward. Or I could just do that. I'm such a geek. The downside of this is, there's the refill thing. You can either lift this off and take it to the kettle. I mean, to the kettle. To the tap. Or force it, if you will. But don't force it down. But I like to use filtered water, because in London, the tap water is disgusting. I miss Yorkshire water so much. Anyway, I had to use a funnel to fill it up. Because the opening at the top is just ridiculously small. Right, so now I've filled. Now I've filled my kettle up. A bit too much. And I've found out that if you do overfill it, you don't have to worry, because what happens is it just pours itself out the nozzle. Which I thought was a good feature, because I am clumsy. Let's get on with the taste test now of these Batchelors pasta sauce. Now it is possible at this moment you're thinking I'm a greedy pig for doing all four, but I've not eaten anything since this morning when I got a double sausage McMuffin from McDonald's. But that was at about 7:30 this morning, and now it is about 4:00, so I've eaten now since then. And which one was my first one? This one. So I've got in from work. I was at work till 2:00. And then dashed home to get my uniform ready to go back to work, and I could be there till something like 11 o'clock at night, and I got to be there in about an hour and a half's time. Ooh, it has thickened up. It has thickened up quite a lot. That's good. And we're going to give that a mix. So this one's cheese and broccoli. Now normally I do like them packets of Batchelors pasta things, but you do in a pan. I mean, you can do it in the microwave if you want, but what I do is, instead of adding water, if you add proper whole milk, because normally I drink skimmed milk, don't I, but if you add whole milk instead of the water, it makes it so thick and creamy. It is so good. And then what you do is you put it in a glass dish, pour it all into a glass dish, cover it with cheese and put it into a hot oven, and then when it gets all nice and hot and bubbling, you take it out. Then what you've got is a lovely pasta bake. Great, isn't it? Yeah. So these are slightly different. These are quicker, but I'm very apprehensive if they're gonna actually taste as good. Yeah, I mean, you can tell you've made them with water. It's a shame I can't put whole milk in this, because then I'd be able to see what it'd be like with milk. I think that's a test. I should do that, shouldn't I? Make one of these with like proper hot milk. And they're not too bad. This is not too bad, actually. It is a little watery for my liking. It's not as creamy as I'd expect it or want it to be. Because it is Batchelors, which is obviously a good brand. I'm not too sure if Batchelors is international. Is it just a UK thing? Owned by Premier Foods, isn't it? Produced in the UK. I don't think you have these in Europe or America or anywhere else, Batchelors stuff, do you? I don't think you do. Let me know in the comment section down below. Scrass. Let me know, please. Is Batchelors international? So, a reasonably good start. The cheese and broccoli one's alright. It was 50p. So, that's, I'm quite happy with that. The next one is mac and cheese. I'll try this mac and cheese one. I will be eating all of these after the camera's stopped recording, because... Yeah, it does smell like... I don't really have a good relationship with these mac and cheese things. Remember that awful Kraft meal thing that I had? Oh, it was Val, wasn't it? Oh, it was so bad. And we'll give this a mix. Just mix it all in. They've all thickened up really nice, which is good. Oh, that Kraft mac and cheese one was rank though. Getting flashbacks from that. Which is obviously in direct competition with Batchelors. But... you don't see the Kraft meals anywhere now. I've not seen them for ages. I think I got them from Iceland as well, didn't I? Yeah, I think I did, didn't I? I've forgotten how much there was, though. Oh, they were £1 each. That bit of pasta was a bit al dente, wasn't it? So this one is... quite cheesy. Yeah, yeah. It's... I'm happy with that because I know it was 50p. And there's plenty of flavour in that. That's lovely. I think there was meant to be 50p as well. I can't remember seeing any price cut thing on it. And it's Iceland anyway, so they're going to be dead cheap. But I'm thinking if there was marked down, I'm sure there was only 75p. I'm trying to remember now. I'm trying to go back in time into my brain and mind. But I'm sure there was just meant to be 50p. That mac and cheese one's actually quite nice. I enjoyed that. The next one is chicken and mushroom. Ooh. This one looks a lot different inside. Now these were the one, this one and the next one was the ones I like the smell of most, wasn't it? So we'll get, oh, this one's really thick. This one's really thick, this one. Well, that's good. That's a good thing. I like things to be thick. It's more filling. Ooh, it smells gorgeous as well, that. Doesn't it? It smells lovely, doesn't it? Well, my hopes are very high for this one. And surprisingly hotter as well. Chicken and mushroom. Not too bad again. These are bloody nice actually. These are going really, really well. It's your generic pot pasta noodly sort of chicken and mushroom, really. If it had sweet corn in it, it would be very much like pot noodle. Except this one has a much thicker and creamier sauce. Mmm. Oh, I hate this. Oh, definitely buy that one again. Oh, this is going up and this is getting better and better. I'm really surprised. In fact, I'm really bloody glad. Because I'm starving hungry. And if these had been a horrible, powdery, over-stodgy, gloopy mess, like the Kraft ones was, I wouldn't have been impressed. Mmm. That one's really good. Oh, I like that. On the top of them, they've put all this thing, like you don't know how to cook these sort of things, that there's a pot with a cross in it, and then it says, pour from a kettle. Which I have disobeyed, because I used a water boiler. Ooh, this one smells spicy. So there's this one. So give that a good mix. Mixy, 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 mix. It's always good to mix. Which I had an idea then of mixing all these together, but I think that's just going to be a waste, because it's so enjoyable, actually. I mean, obviously I'm hungry and everything tastes better when you're starving hungry, doesn't it? But these are much better than I expected, actually. Although I am going to say they're not as good as when you make them yourself. So like the pasta bake idea thing that they do, you know, make it yourself, but use whole milk, don't use water like it tells you to. and make it all up in the pan, get it all up and bubbling, then put it into a glass dish, put it in an oven, that's hot enough. Obviously before you put it in the oven, cover it with cheese, lots of cheese, and mix into a nice cheesy pasta bake. And I'm really wanting that now, can you tell? Because I've told you twice. So this is cheese and pancetta. It's nice for what it is, this one. This isn't my cup of tea, but I do like the branch out of flavouring. You know, I respect them for that. Yeah. And this isn't my least favourite just because of my personal taste. It's got a good flavour. It's thick and creamy like the other three. It's nice and... it's not got a hollow taste. None of it tastes hollow or bland or anything. They're actually quite good. If anyone's watching this and you're thinking, yeah, but blah, 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 it's all mass-produced, this, that, and the other. I don't care about any of that. I'm really enjoying these, and they were dead cheap. Bear in mind, I paid £2 for all this together. There's loads there, and I liked it very much. My favourite, it's hard to choose between the first three. I probably wouldn't buy this one again, but that's just my personal taste and flavour of. That's just a personal thing, but I can tell that people who'd love that sort of flavour would definitely like this. So that's my review. They're good! I'm so happy. Right, let me know in the comment section down below if you buy these sort of things, or do you prefer pot noodle? Or maybe you do like them craft meal things. Craft doesn't really have a brand of itself in the UK. Craft usually just buys all the big British brands. And that's how it gets its way in this country. But Kraft itself doesn't really have much of a name. You know, it's people think of Dairy as a brand rather than Kraft Dairy, or people think of Cadbury rather than Kraft Cadbury. But that, now I'm just opening up the comment section to all sorts of palaver. So anyway, thanks for watching. Please scratch, and I'll see you when I see you. Bye! Of course, the solution is, if you don't like whatever you don't like, you can always solve the problem with lots of tomato sauce. Ketchup, if you will. I say tomato sauce. Do you say ketchup or tomato sauce?